Last week, US and North Korean officials met in Geneva to explore a possible resumption of six-party talks over North Korea's nuclear program. At the meeting was US Ambassador Stephen Bosworth, Special Representative of Obama Administration's for North Korea policy. And today he's with me here to discuss more. Welcome, Ambassador.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
That was your final appearance as Special Representative.
Yes, I am now no longer Special Representative.
Where do you think the talks, you know, where do you think it were left off? Are the six-party talks back on the table?
There are certainly on the table. We're not back at the table. But my own view, and with a certain amount of optimism, is that we will be back in a formal dialogue with the North Koreans on the issues of substance sometime in the relatively near future, both perhaps bilaterally, but also in the multilateral six-party talks.
And do you have a sense of timing when that might happen?
No, I really don't. I think it could happen as soon as a couple of months from now. It may be sometime later next year. But I think there is a certain amount of momentum that is taking us back to that. The North Koreans clearly would like to get back to the table. That's not saying that they're prepared to make all sorts of deals. But I think at the moment they find their interest would probably be better served by being back at the table than not back at the table.
Several analysts in the United States have now suggested that denuclearization is not something that the North Koreans are interested in. It's probably the best strategy U.S. has at this point, maybe containment. What is your assessment? Is denuclearization on the cards?
Well, I think whether it's in the cards or not, we cannot abandon that as our ultimate goal. It's important to the countries in the region. It's important to us because it affects our global non-proliferation interests and our global non-proliferation regime or norms. So I don't think we're going to say suddenly, oh, we can't achieve denuclearization. We have to keep that as our long-term goal. Now, realistically, along the way, there are things I think we could possibly get through negotiations with North Korea that would be very helpful. Some limitations on their production of new fissile material, some assurances or actual agreements on the things involving proliferation of nuclear weapons. All sorts of things that I think are well worth trying to get.
North Korea has an impending leadership transition.
Yes. Do
you have a sense if the new leadership thinks in any way differently about the nuclear program, engagement with the West, future of the country, any indication of any change?
Well, first of all, we don't have any idea when that leadership transition is likely to occur. I think most people believe that it will not occur as long as Kim Jong-il is alive. But my own view is that their policies aren't going to change all that much. The transition could have some effect on their domestic condition and on their ability to sustain their policies. But I would not expect a new regime or a new leadership in the North Korean regime to suddenly do an about-face and say that they're prepared to do things that the current administration has not been willing to do.
And how about China? What is your sense of where do they stand vis-a-vis their policy on North Korea? Has that changed in any way?
No, I don't think it's changed. I think China faces a dilemma with regard to North Korea. On the one hand, they don't want North Korea to be a permanent nuclear weapon state, just as we don't want them to. On the other hand, they also don't want North Korea to collapse. They don't want a reunified Korean Peninsula under South Korean organization with a military relationship with the United States. So they're pursuing a course that has to take account of these two goals, both of them very fundamental, but which may not always be achievable at the same time.
So finally, what would be your pearls of wisdom to your successor when trying to deal with North Korea?
To be patient, to understand that they have their perceptions of their national interest, and we can't ignore those, and that we have to stay engaged. We have to continue to be willing to talk to them, as difficult as that can be, both politically and materially.
Ambassador, thank you so much for
your time. You're very welcome. My pleasure.